911 emergency.
San Francisco 911. 911 emergency.
He's trying to kill me. Please hurry.
Ma'am, can you go outside?
He's in the living room. Please hurry.
Ma'am, listen to me. The police are on their way right now.
He's in the hall.
Ma'am, go into another room, lock yourself in, and try to leave out the back door.
Oh, my God. He's going to kill me. He's breaking down the door.
Ma'am? Ma'am?
Hey, sorry to interrupt Pete's going away dinner.
You got me before it started.
You hear the 911 call? No woman is here, and that was definitely a woman's voice.
That's definitely a man.
Fred Ostner, 35. Wallet was in his back pocket. He lived two houses down.
So the caller's a woman. She gives this address. The patrol guards show up and find only him?
The caller identified herself as Corinne Stevens. She lives here. Neighbor says her husband's away on business.
Two head wounds, blunt object, and then he starts in with a knife.
This guy's butchered.
18 stab wounds and counting.
Is that a crystal rabbit?
The killer picked it up and smashed it into his skull.
That's an enraged killer.
Enraged like a jealous husband? Are there any drag marks around? Any signs she was hurt?
No.
So he took her in with him.
Why am I here? What is this place? I don't understand. Why are you doing this? Why won't you talk? Please. Please. Talk to me. Why are you doing this?
Missing 10 hours.
What is this, kidnapping?
Off the record.
Lens, it has been so long since we were on the record, I've put the record away.
10 hours and no ransom demand.
Where's the husband?
He was at a hotel in Colorado Springs. He checked out at midnight, night before last. If he drives fast enough, he just makes it in time. We tried to reach him on his cell, but it's not turned on. So, Corinne gets home and turns the alarm system off at 8:02 p.m.
The victim, Fred Ostner, did he come in with Corinne?
Yeah, it looks that way. Our guest, the killer, is waiting inside. He sees Fred. They struggle. Corinne runs for the media room and locks the door. That's where the call came from. The killer drops Fred with his crystal rabbit and then stabs him. Fred's watch is smashed at 8:11 p.m. 8:12 p.m., Corinne calls 911 from the media room.
You're supposed to be home recuperating. It was a gunshot, after all.
I'm recuperated. How do you know where Corinne was when she called 911?
The doorknob. He snapped it when he forced his way in.
So what happened with Pete last night?
I got the page at the restaurant before we even sat down. That's okay, I got 2 days before he leaves.
Hey, Linz. I just brought in the husband. Are you people nuts?
Why would I kidnap my own wife?
You have a temper. Your wife's having an affair.
With Fred. He's our friend. He checks on Corinne when I'm away. I asked him to. Look, I stopped in Reno on the way back and I slept. Talked to the hotel staff. I left my cell phone there.
We're looking into it.
Mr. Stevens, we're checking out the crystal rabbit the killer used to hit Fred. If we find one fingerprint...
What did he use?
The killer picked up a crystal rabbit and hit Mr. Ostner in the head.
We don't own any crystal rabbit.
Excuse me a moment.
I know what you're thinking. She's 25, a trophy wife. I didn't do this.
Can you think of anyone who might have a grudge against you? Anyone your wife mentioned?
No. I don't know. No one. You have to find Corinne. Please.
A minute. His alibi checks out. He did sleep in Reno. The forensics found no prints on the rabbit. Not the husband, the victim, or the missing woman. So the killer must have brought it with him.
Who brings a crystal figurine to a kidnapping?
Maybe it was message to the husband?
He was wearing gloves. There was no fingerprints. That's not a message to the husband, that's a message to us.
Hey. Your victim has two head wounds, one from the glass rabbit. The other, I think, came from the killer's right shoe. He kicked Ostner post-mortem. This is from the second wound. There's something in the matted hair. I think it's blue paint. I sent samples to the lab.
What kind of knife did he use?
Serrated.
And he's strong. He stabs with tremendous force.
Is there a small indentation at the bottom of every wound? Like from the base of the knife slamming against the skin?
Maybe, but how could you... You think it's the kiss me not killer? Lindsay, his only victims were women.
And he took Corinne Stevens with him.
Lindsay, all three women had their lips sewn together, not him.
Osner wasn't his intended victim. It was Corinne he wanted, and Fred Osner interrupted him.
And the crystal rabbit?
Well, look at all the other crime scenes. The mouse, the tub, the key, the lilacs. All symbols of some sort of ritual. And the crystal rabbit was another one. He meant it for Corinne Stevens, but he broke it when he killed Fred Osner. He's back. He's killing again, and he's got his next victim.
Come in.
Hi.
Hi.
I was just taking a quick shower. I'm sorry I didn't come home last night.
Well, Martha and I spent some quality time.
Really?
Yeah, now that you're here, maybe we can have some.
Mm. You have no idea how good that sounds, but I have to get back to work.
Yeah, sure. No, I understand. You know, work's work. Assuming that that's what this is all about.
I think I'm running away because you're leaving.
I think you're running away because I'm leaving.
Believe me, that's not it.
Is this something I can ask you about?
I call him the Kiss Me Not Killer. He started 5 years ago. He tortures women, sews their lips shut. Totally freaking you out?
No, you're not.
Hunting this guy took over my life. I became obsessed. I lost my marriage. I lost perspective on everything.
Why this one? Why bring this one, huh?
If I knew why he chose these women, if I could figure that out, then I could understand him. I have to finish this. It's the only way that I can get him out of my life. He's taken another woman, Pete, and I have to find him before he kills her.
You have to go. Do what you have to do. Just go.
Crime scene is clean except for the paint and residue in the hair.
Why in the hair and not on the carpet?
Okay, well, you see these threads? Lab says that there's stitches that hold the upper to the sole of the shoe. The paint was held in by the threads.
Lieutenant?
Yeah.
Here you go.
Thank you.
So, kicked him in the head. Lost her temper. Stupid.
Stare at that board long enough, you'll see a sailboat.
Hey, Wheeler.
Hey, so the lab says the paint from the killer's shoe is called Skylar Blue.
It's a specialty paint used for restoring old cars and trucks.
How old?
We're talking Elvis and Hula Hoops.
5 dealers in the Bay Area carry it. 3 of them don't have it in stock. The 4th one just got his first shipment in 6 months.
You said 5 dealers?
No, the 5th one has it in stock. His name is John Harris.
Let's go.
Skylar Blue. Well, not much call for it unless you own a 55 pickup.
Was it only used in 1955?
June 55 to April 58. People got tired of the dark blue, this one sort of a turquoise robin's egg, and people got tired of that. Americans and their cars were picky.
Have you sold any recently?
Yeah, I can check.
How good are your records?
Oh, well, at 290 gallon, it's not exactly walking out the door. We're not talking a lot of people.
Well, please give us a list and add your employees and day laborers for the last 5 years.
I'll fax it over right away.
No, we'll wait for it now.
This is serious.
Where were you last night around 8, Mr. Harris?
Gee, I was here.
We're open till 9. I have the surveillance tapes.
Great. We'll take those and the list of customers and employees.
Right away.
Hey, still no sign of Corinne Stevens. We re-canvassed the neighborhood.
What about the paint dealers?
Jacoby and Wheeler are running the customers and the employees through NCIC, so for nothing.
Hey, Lynch, John Harris, the paint dealer we saw this morning, he had a 15-year-old daughter. She ran away 16 years ago, disappeared. A lot of cops worked on the case on and off, especially after they found her dead. One of the cops was your dad.
Where did they find her body?
It was 5 years ago. Her remains were dug up in a park near San Mateo.
I need a minute. It's about a case.
Must be pretty big for you to come see the old man. We speak twice in the last 7 years, and suddenly I'm your new best friend.
Can I come in?
Always welcome here. You want some tea? I got that Scottish brunch stuff you like.
Scottish breakfast, and you hate it.
But I stocked up on it. I figured eventually you'd come to visit.
This isn't a visit.
If that's the way you want to play it. What's the case?
So, a serial killer I've been working a few years.
Kiss me not? Is there a new victim? I didn't hear.
We were trying to keep it quiet. He took a woman last night. Hopefully she's still alive.
What can I do for you?
John Harris, auto paint dealer, his daughter ran away. Does that ring any bells?
Harris? Oh, yeah. Daughter's name was Rachel, right? Yeah, I worked that case a couple of weeks.
You were a homicide, so why'd you work it if she was a runaway?
The family said she was a runaway, but nobody bought it. Didn't take any clothes, didn't tell anybody she was leaving. We expected to find her body any day. Only about a decade off.
Who are you looking at for the killer?
A couple of us like the Harris's son.
Billy?
Yeah.
He was in the file.
12 years old. Strange kid. Of course, Harris and his wife didn't want to hear it.
But could a boy that age kill a 15-year-old girl and dispose of the body?
Seen worse. We kept an eye on him. He got into some fights in and out of juvie. Kid always just seemed wrong.
Jacoby?
Hey, what do you got on Billy Harris?
Well, he works in his father's shop. No, Harris didn't have him on the employees list. Shift manager says he's been out sick for 3 days.
He works in his father's shop?
Ask Jacoby.
I know what to ask Jacoby. Where does he...
He lives in his father's house. Don't get snippy over the phone.
Get a warrant, text me the address, and I'll meet you there. I gotta go.
Anything else I can do?
No, I just came for the information. Thanks.
Sure, kid. Hey. Be careful.
Always am.
I don't understand. Why are you looking for Billy? What is this about?
Take Mr. Harris out of here.
This isn't right. This is my house.
Get him out of here.
Lindsay, nothing in the basement.
DMV report. Billy Harris has got a 1956 F-100 pickup. Color blue.
Thanks. The layout of this room look familiar?
This is the daughter's room a long time ago. Just like in the file photos.
Mm-hmm.
No sign of Corinne Stevens in this house. No blue pickup truck in the garage.
Thanks. It's not here because he's driving it.
Strange kid.
Jacoby?
The crystal rabbit, the lilacs, the brass tub, all of these things belonged to Rachel Harris when she was 15. Billy Harris is a kiss me not killer.
How much longer do we have, and will he keep Corinne alive?
He keeps her and Rice alive 6 days.
I know a shrink in juvie where Billy spent time. I just talked to him. I can't tell you anything, doctor-patient privilege, but he's my friend. I know this guy. He'll help us.
Cindy, this isn't your job. You can get in a lot of trouble.
Let's have the fun.
I don't know where Billy is. I do know that he's a good kid.
Your list of employees, you didn't put Billy on it.
I don't think of Billy as an employee. He's my son. This is a nightmare.
Lindsay. If Harris knew what Billy was doing, he didn't do it with him. We pulled his credit cards. The night Sarah Rice disappeared, he was in Atlanta at a car show.
Thanks.
Sure.
If Billy goes hunting and doesn't tell you where.
Maybe. I wasn't listening. He likes to hunt. I don't even know how to fire a gun.
Might any of his friends know?
No, he's sort of a loner.
When your daughter Rachel disappeared, we understand that the police told you they thought Billy might have done it.
Yeah. Yeah. And when they said that to my wife, it killed her. She died 2 months later.
Mr. Harris, we understand the feeling of needing to protect your son, but there is a woman's life at stake. Please think about what you're doing. He knows where Billy is.
I don't know.
He jumped out of his chair when I brought up Rachel. You don't think he's protecting Billy?
No, he's not. Harris isn't protecting his son. He's protecting himself. Rachel Harris was buried in a vinyl duffel, handles on the side, dried blood on it.
Didn't they test the blood?
Too small a sample at the time. I had them compare the DNA from the blood speck to the DNA from Billy Harris's hairbrush.
It's a partial match.
It's his father's blood.
So John Harris killed and buried his daughter and then claimed she ran away.
We can charge Harris, offer him a plea to help us find his son.
Okay, let's get him charged. But if this guy's as smart as I think he isn't gonna help us with anything. Boxer, homicide.
Hello, Lindsay.
Yeah, who's this?
Let my father go. If you want to keep Corinne alive.
Billy?
You want to help Corinne, right?
Yes. Yes, I do. Let me talk to her.
No games.
Let my father go.
Damn it.
Not enough time to trace the call.
What do you say? Linz?
He said that if we didn't let John go, he would kill Corinne.
Hey, I got here as fast as I could.
I'm sorry, I probably sound a little freaked out when I called.
So are you sure it's Billy Harris?
Yeah. But you know what, Claire? It was partly a relief.
Okay.
Well, Billy Harris has always been this phantom. Now I know what he looks like. I know what he sounds like. I took Pete up to the attic this morning and showed him Crazy Lindsay's serial killer exhibit.
What happened?
He had a bunch of questions. I don't know if he'll get past it.
Of course he will. He loves you.
It's a little early to be talking about love.
Lindsay, he sleeps at your place when he's not in a hotel. He cooks. He walks your dog. He puts up with your crazy hours and never complains. That's not love?
That would be amazing. If I wasn't spending his last day here living inside Billy Harris's head.
Which is what we all rely on you to do, and I'm sure Pete understands that.
Cindy called. She said she has something we'll want to see. Hey. I have Billy's notebooks from Juvie Hall. My friend said he could lose his license, so he needs them back when we're done. Look at this. It's from 1993.
He was thinking about it even as a kid.
This. serial killer at age 12. He wasn't killing anyone. This was in the back of his notebook. Here's the freaky thing. The first drawing shows up 2 weeks after Rachel disappeared. Why would he draw her like that if he didn't know she was dead yet?
Unless he did. That's what the drawings mean. John Harris killed Rachel and Billy saw it happen. He knew his sister was dead.
He draws her with her lips sewn shut.
That's how a 12-year-old tells us what happened. It's about keeping the secret. It's about the silence. John must have threatened Billy and told him to keep quiet about it. Why these women, Billy? Why do you choose them? All this time. All this time, it's been right here in front of me.
Where?
Look at Corinne Stevens and her husband, and then look at the past three victims. Each victim is a young woman with an older man in her life. Sarah Rice had the boyfriend, Melissa Paquin, her sick father, Elaine Lewis, and the older boss. That's all about Rachel. With each victim, Billy is reenacting his father's crime and the order not to tell. That's Billy's life. That's the only thing that's important to him.
Quiet! Quiet! Quiet!
Boxer, homicide.
Hey, beautiful.
Hi, Pete. How's it going?
I'm at the hotel. I'm gonna see you before I go, right?
Yeah, I'd really like that. I'd really, really like that.
Because we should finish our conversation.
Pete, I gotta go, okay?
Sure, yeah, okay.
I'll call you later. Boxer, homicide.
You didn't do what I asked, Lindsay.
You still have my father.
Well, Billy, let's talk about it.
You want to be my friend?
I want to tell you that I know what happened. I know what your father did to you and your sister.
Too late.
You should have listened.
I almost have him.
Billy, I'm listening now. What do you want to tell me?
You made me do it again.
What are you talking about? Billy.
Lindsay.
By the way,
nice dog.
He's calling from your apartment.
He left Corinne Stevens in my bed. I get to go tell Richard Stevens that his wife is dead. No. Dead because of me.
She's blaming herself.
An endless loop in her head saying it's her fault.
Turn it off because you're wrong. Corinne Stevens has been in rigor for more than a day. She was killed 6 to 9 hours after she was abducted, and she was already dead when Billy asked for his father's release.
Yeah, stop feeling guilty. We need you at 100% to catch this guy.
I don't want another woman on my table with her lips sewn shut. So what are we gonna do about it?
Find the sailboat yet?
His sister's death was the single most defining moment in Billy Harris's life. Not his mother's love, not his first home run, not his first kiss. Witnessing his sister's murder obliterated anything and everything that came before or after that. That's his obsession with his father.
Why did he wait to start killing?
They found Rachel's body, threatened to expose the secret. That's what provoked him before. That's how I provoke him now. You want your father out of police custody? You want us to keep your secret? See how you like it when it's plastered all over the news.
Well over a decade since the initial trail went cold, new evidence has surfaced that has seemingly broken this case wide open for investigators. And now this man, John Harris, has been arrested for the murder of his 15-year-old daughter, Rachel. The investigation had been...
All the morning shows ran it. Billy will see it. He'll call back.
If he doesn't...
Tommy won't let it go. Espresso, wheat. You're looking for Billy. You're reupholstering.
Married to a civilian who teaches kindergarten. What can I say?
She thinks the job turns off when you leave the building.
Well, that's one problem you didn't have with me.
Hey, Lindsay, call for you. They're sending it up. They think it's him.
Billy?
Why'd you push me?
I don't want to push you. I want to talk to you.
No, Lindsay, no talking. This time, I'm not forgiving you. You took something that belongs to me.
Which means I had to do the same.
45435.
That's my cell phone. How'd you get that number?
See you soon.
My cell phone's on my desk.
Is anything missing from your apartment?
I haven't been back to the apartment since Claire took the body out.
Okay, he said he took something of yours. Maybe he doesn't mean an object. Maybe he is talking about a person.
I saw Cindy and Jill in Jill's office. I saw Claire in the hall 20 minutes ago. No messages. Oh, my God, he means Pete. It's an IP address. Jacoby.
Can we run a trace on this site?
It'll take days to go through all the servers.
My God, it's your dad.
Bring me my father. I'll give you yours in exchange. You have 5 minutes to decide, Inspector, or I'll blow his brains out.
It's not a rescue, Vince. It's a suicide mission.
I tell Billy it's possible or he blows Marty's head off.
Think. It was a secret. Now it's out. Game over. He wants to kill you, Lindsay, and then himself.
If it was your father, what would you do? Boxer.
What's your answer, Lindsay?
We have a deal. Where do we meet?
15.7 miles east on Midway Road. 5 o'clock. Don't bring company.
I want to speak to my father.
You can talk when you get here. We have an hour to figure out how we do this so you and your dad don't die.
Okay, I got an idea, but we're gonna need some help.
Lieutenant Hogan, to Thorn FBI.
Thanks for coming. Inspector Lindsay Boxer.
I appreciate your help.
Inspector, you've handled us as well as anyone could. We're here to help whatever way we can.
This is the house in Solano County where the hostage is being held.
It's an old hunting cabin, only structure within a 5 mile radius.
It's cattle country. You'd see us coming from a mile away. It's too far for a sniper to get a shot.
Since we can't get a bullet in there, I was thinking of something more up close and personal.
What'd you have in mind?
Small explosive, like a flashbang grenade with a radio signal trigger.
My guys can do that. How do you get it in his hand?
Put it in something he wants. You get a grenade in that?
Sure. We'll put the bear in a bag, you bring it to him. We'll wire your jacket for a mic. You get him to hold it, send us the signal. Carl can remote detonate the bomb.
How far away do I have to be?
6 to 8 feet. 6 to 8 feet at least. If there are any surprises, you let us know. We'll be there in 30 seconds.
A lot can happen in 30 seconds.
The DA found a cooperative judge. Billy's dad pleads down to manslaughter on the murder of Rachel, and in exchange, he agrees to go with you.
Let's go.
Hey.
Hey.
We just wanted to ask, because we are taking you to dinner after all this. Pizza, Japanese, or Greek?
We want to hear all about the big adventure.
And your goodbye with Pete, what he said, what you said.
Yeah, he's leaving at 9, so I may not make it.
Not if you talk that way, you won't.
Pizza, Japanese, Greek. You pick. Surprise me. Remember, if I don't make it out of this, I never liked you that much anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Head down.
These restraints are excessive.
That's what criminals wear. You know the main reason parents kill kids? Because daddy wants something the child won't give. That's what happened, isn't it? You wanted her, and she fought back, and Billy saw the whole thing. He saw you try to take her. He saw you kill her. How'd you keep him quiet?
What a pretty speech.
You made your son a monster. He is what he is because of you.
You don't understand anything.
She's got the bear and it's in the bag.
Are we getting a signal from her, Mike?
The signal is clear.
Everyone's set.
We have sound on Lindsay and Harris now.
I don't see Billy anywhere.
He's here. His truck's behind the cabin.
Billy?
Drop the bag, hand on your head.
Where's my father?
In a minute.
We had a deal, Billy. Where is he?
I said shut up. Daddy? Sorry. It's falling apart. I can't keep it inside anymore.
What the hell are you talking about? What's falling apart?
I don't like where this is going.
She's okay. She knows what she's doing.
I tried to protect you. I tried to keep the secret.
Not another word.
I did what you said, Daddy. Never tell. Never tell. Never tell. Never tell. Never tell. Never tell. I was a good boy. And they found Rachel. I love you, Daddy. Your turn. Inside. What are you doing?
I have some things that you want.
What?
It was things that belonged to Rachel.
Get ready to blow it. Remember, on her signal.
No. No, I don't want those.
Billy.
Move.
We gotta get her out of that.
We can't.
She doesn't have the flash bomb. She's helpless.
If we go in now, Lindsay and her dad are dead before we get in the house.
Go inside.
Hey, kid.
No talking. You stop right there. You stay. She was beautiful.
Yeah, Billy, she was.
I didn't save her from Daddy.
You couldn't. You were too young.
I was too scared. I could have saved her. I could have saved her. I didn't save her. I didn't stop.
You shouldn't have come here, Lindsay.
Quiet, old man.
Billy,
Stop!
This has nothing to do with my father. Okay, let him go.
Well, he stays.
What happened to Rachel? It wasn't your fault. It was your father's. So you know what that means? You can stop with all of this. Your father's gone. You don't have to keep a secret anymore.
The secret's out. You let the secret out. Tell her she's a bad daughter, and this is all her fault. Stay right there.
No.
She's a screw-up. She's a waste of
Billy.
Flesh and bone. She doesn't deserve to live. Say it!
I love you, baby. I love you with all my heart.
Go! Go!
All units, move! Said it was a clean in and out. I'm gonna be fine.
I'll come check on you later tonight.
You don't have to do that.
I know.
Thanks for coming to get me, baby.
I'll see you in a couple hours.
Yeah.
You did okay today. I may have to treat you with something resembling respect.
Yeah, and don't go overboard.
Press got wind of what happened. PIO wants to know if you feel up to talking to some reporters.
No. I gotta get to the airport. You'll handle it for me, okay?
What are you doing?
Excuse me, sorry.
Passport.
SOPD, I need to get to gate 24.
Sorry, ma'am, I can't let you do that.
There's no problem. I just need to get in there. It'll only be a minute.
Ma'am, I can't let you in without an okay from my supervisor.
No, I can't wait. I need to talk to someone, okay? He is on the 910 to Phnom Penh, which is leaving in 18 minutes. And look, if I don't say goodbye to this man, I am going to regret it for the rest of my life. So can you just please let me in?
You should probably let her go. Hi.
What are you doing out here?
Waiting for you.
Does this mean you're staying?
It means there's a flight to Taipei in 4 hours. It gets me to Cambodia tomorrow. It also means I couldn't leave without talking to you.
Okay, there's like a thousand things that I want to say right now, so. Okay, for a long time, I've been hanging on to a lot of feelings about everything. And I finally finished this nightmare. And the point I'm trying to make is that I think I can be happy. Well, I want to be happy. And I'm just really sorry that I didn't realize it until you were about to leave. And I just wanted you to know that I'm gonna miss you more than I want to think about.
It's nice to hear, Lance. Just take Here's the thing. This doesn't have to end. I mean, I don't get a lot of time off, but when I do, I'd like to come back to you. What I'm saying is that between my vacations, yours, cell phones, a little patience, we can make it work. It's only a year. Doesn't sound like much of an offer.
Yes. I would like that.
Yes?
Yes. Yes. I would like that.
I would like that very much.
Hey. Sorry I'm late. I had to stop at the bureau and get my stuff back.
No problem. So, how was the goodbye?
It was not so much a goodbye as it was a continuation.
He's staying.
No. But he's coming back from time to time. Eventually. It's better than it sounds. It is.
The long distance thing never works. Take it from me.
Hello, a little support, maybe?
She's right. He's been pretty great so far.
Exactly. And I can take some vacation time and go visit him.
Uh-huh. When was the last time you took a vacation?
7th grade, maybe?
Okay, you know what? You people have absolutely no faith in romance or two people who care about each other. Boxer.
$10 says in half hour from now, we're at a crime scene.
I was so looking forward to shrimp.
I don't understand. I thought he was fine. I thought it was nothing. No, never mind. Yeah, I'll be right there.
Vince.
It's my dad.